There is a link here between the income statement and the balance sheet. The income realized or losses incurred in the income statement is reflected in the equity section of the balance sheet, through the retained earnings line item. So let us talk about the statement of retained earnings. This statement also starts with a header showing the name of the company, the name of the statement, and the period covered by the statement. Then we have few items here in the statement. The net income for the current period. This is brought here from the income statement for the current reporting period. Then we have the beginning balance of retained earnings. And as we said in the previous video, it shows the sum of the income realized or losses incurred during the previous reporting period starting from day one in business. We will cover that in detail in this course, so let us assume that the balance is zero for now. The dividends line item shows the profit distributions declared to the owners of the business during the current period. By adding the beginning balance to the income for the current year, less the dividends, we get the ending balance of the retained earnings, which is reflected in the equity section in the balance sheet. This link between the income statement and the balance sheet highlights an important fact, which is that profitable business operations increase the equity, and therefore strengthens the financial position of the business. Losses suffered by the business decreases the equity and therefore weakens the financial position of the business. The fourth statement of the financial statements is the statement of cash flows, and this statement focuses on the cash of the business. It shows from where the cash was obtained, and where it was spent during the reporting period. We will discuss that statement in a separate video in this course. So, these are the four financial statements that accountants prepare each reporting period. To produce these statements, accountants follow a series of steps known as the accounting cycle. Let us talk about that in the following video.